check that out. Kicking it old school, 90s old school for the Chicago scene. I'm Tom Barnes, and I am in Lincoln Park at a Nickelodeon pop-up bar. So that's why you see all this. I'm going to talk to Mark. Somebody might even get slimed. You never know what you might get here on the Chicago scene. So let's head inside, yeah? All right, so people of a certain age know Nickelodeon. They know the 90s well. And Mark has recreated some of our finest childhood memories. How you doing, Mark?
Great. Thanks for coming by.
Yeah, no problem. So talk about this bit. So we're at Replay in Lincoln Park. You've recreated a little bit of the Nickelodeon old school fun, and that's what is going on in this back part of the space, right?
Yeah, well, the entire space, and we're calling it Nick Arcade, throwback to the 90s through July 11th right now. Obviously, we're representing the Nickelodeon brand.
For sure.
And some of the most iconic properties of the 90s, CatDog. And then over here, we've got Doug.
Yeah, so I'm going to swing by over here. So how do you guys do this? Like, who makes this?
We've got a great team of artists. They call themselves the Pop-Up Squad. Mm-hmm. And they've been working on pop-ups with me for almost 5 years now.
So the same folks that were behind Schitt's Creek and Stranger Things, all those
all
things?
All of the same guys.
Yeah, you guys are kind of now famous for all your pop-up stuff that you guys do.
Yeah, we've been doing... The first one we did was Moe's Tavern in 2016. Right. And then... I've been rolling ever since. So here we've got Rugrats represented, obviously, another iconic show of the 90s that people love taking pictures in front of and hanging out and reliving their childhood.
Yeah, I'm sure this is like a very Instagrammable thing that people come and take pictures of.
Yes.
How do you guys pick out what you do for your pop-ups? I'm gonna swing around here.
I mean, there's no science to it. Sometimes we do a little polling on Facebook. Sometimes one of the artists is inspired and has kind of leads the charge and says, hey, we've got to do, 90s, or we've got to do Stranger Things. And we just kind of, there's no science to it, honestly.
Got
it's just
it.
Fun.
What's happening here?
Wild Thornberries. One of the other great, great shows of 90s Nick. You can get in that bus, actually. Yeah, I'll walk in there.
Oh, yeah, go on in there. Let's see that.
So people, this is where they get in and obviously... pose.
Well, let me get my photo shoot down here.
Yeah,
look at
that's exactly what happened. So we'll
have super cool.
Four people in here taking pictures.
So for people who might be wondering, in terms of best way to come here, reservations or anything like that, what's the best way for that to happen?
So reservations aren't required. We are offering reservations and they're suggested at peak times. So Thursday, Friday, Saturday, 7 to 11, we've been at capacity. So you can go on our Facebook page, Replay Lincoln Park, or on our website, replaylincolnpark.com. And reservations are through Talk. And it's $20, but you get $20 in drinks, so it's essentially free. And here's one of my favorites.
Oh, yeah, I was going to ask you, what are you drinking there?
Rocko's Mango Life. So it's a frozen mango slushy. This one's virgin, but we spike it with dark rum or tequila or whatever you want, really. But those are the two suggested toppings or spikings.
Gotcha. And so nothing would be complete without a trip down memory lane with Nickelodeon and everything else, but the one and only Double Dare, getting slime, that whole thing. And that's, you guys do offer something like that, or are we just doing something fun specifically
We are sliming people on our Wednesday cycle bingo night. We're probably going to do it on a Thursday trivia. We're doing some themed 90s trivia coming up. But this Wednesday coming up during our Psycho Bingo from 8 to 11 o'clock or so, we're going to be sliming people.
Awesome. So I think we should get a little example of that. I think we've recruited Isabel. Come on over here real quick, Isabel, because you volunteered to get slime. You've never been slimed before. So Mark, you ready to do the honors?
I'm going to do it off camera, though.
Off camera. That's fine. So we're going to get set here in a second. So everybody just hang out for a second. And you ready, Isabel?
I'm ready.
All right, she's gonna get slime, so we're gonna cut to that in 2 seconds.
It seems like it's nice and cold.
Wait, it's so cold.
That's perfect. It looks it looks great because now her whole face is covered.
Yay!
Okay, so Isabel, you've been slimed. How does it feel? Is it everything you thought it would be and more?
It was amazing. I think everyone should try it.
I heard you, when you first fell, you said it smelled good.
It does. I thought it was gonna smell super gross and slimy, I guess, but it actually smells really good.
Yeah, so it got you pretty good here. You got you all over your shirt there. I hope you're wearing your Sunday best.
Yeah.
And then there's the slime. But you got a pair of goggles out of it. So definitely worth it, right?
Thankfully. I would not have been able to see without those, for sure.
And this is here till July 11th. Did I get that right?
Correct. Yeah, July 11th, every day, 7 days a week.
July 11th, every day, 7 days a week. I appreciate it, Isabel. Thank you, Mark. T-B-A-R-N-E-S. At WGNTV.com. That's T-Barnes at WGNTV.com. If you have a suggestion for the Chicago scene. Until then, get slimed, everybody.